Joseph Goebbels, Hitler's minister of propaganda, once said, "If you tell a lie big enough and keep repeating it, people will eventually come to believe it." Good morning, adjudicators and fellow contestants. When is it good to lie? As we have come to realize, people don't always want to hear the truth. To be honest, the truth sucks. Telling the truth all the time can be tricky, which is why we lie. In a 10-minute conversation with a stranger, a woman is said to lie 3 times, whereas a man is said to lie 6 times. A college student is likely to lie to their mom once in every 5 interactions. Now, special experts, such as forensic psychologists who work with criminals, say that it is quite easy to detect when a person is lying by simply studying their body language. Clues such as quick or sharp head turns, a change in breathing, and the big one, little or no eye contact, are all telltale signs which show that a person is not telling the truth. 3 lies I always hear my dad say are, "You look fine, honey. I promise you I won't fall asleep during this movie. And I didn't finish them, I only had 2. 3 lies I always hear my mom say are, "I'll get your PlayStation game next month. I'm just popping in for a minute. It won't take long." And the notorious one, "I don't snore." Now, we have seen how politicians use lies to gain votes, or how lies were used by leaders such as Hitler to persecute and annihilate more than 15 million people during World War II. So, if lying is mostly wrong, then where is it good to lie? Apparently, studies have shown that sometimes lies can benefit you and even save yours or someone else's life. Now, the difference between a real lie and a white lie is a white lie is used to get you out of awkward situations or protect someone's feelings. The best white lies have some truth in them. For example, parents sometimes use white lies in order to protect the innocence of their children by not giving them too much graphic detail about the birds and the bees at a very young age. In cases where a patient has a fatal illness, doctors sometimes distort the prognosis rather than telling them that they do not have long to live. And so through this sense of false hope and positive thinking, some people end up living longer than expected. Some white lies can be used to avoid hurting people's feelings. For example, a child walks up to you with the drawing of an eagle that they drew, and you know very well that that eagle looks like a llama. But instead of saying, "Hey kid, give up your jeans and become your next Vanguard," you could say, "Wow, very nice. But how about next time you make the neck shorter, only have 1 pair of wings, and add feathers?" This way, you don't hurt the child's feelings, and you add creative criticism, which will hopefully help you in the future. In some cases, the truth is just not an option. For instance, a murderer walks up to your house, knocks on your door, and asks where your mom is. Now, a bad child would just say that she's upstairs, whereas a good child would say that she's not here, and you can leave a note for her. A white lie can also be used when answering one of the most frequently asked questions about a female species. "Do these jeans make me look fat?" Now, a man that does not value his life would say yes, whereas a man that does value his life would say no, "You look beautiful." You see, white lies can be the difference between life or death. So, as you can see, lies can sometimes benefit you in many different situations. So remember, folks, lie responsibly, but little lies can lead to much bigger ones. Thank you.